welcome back to Star Trek Online. Yes, I still have a frog in my throat, and it's very irritating. So, I didn't get to grind anything between this and the last day. Life got in the way. So, first thing we have to do today is to actually use some skill points. So, let's see. Starship energy weapons. Improves all energy weapon damage. Projectile weapon structural integrity. Improves your ship's hull strength. That could be useful. Hull repair, warp core efficiency. Okay. Gives me more power to work with. Subsystem repair, yeah. Let's see, what else do we have? Shield emitters. Oh, go away. Yeah, let me see. One of the combat specialist, and I think I'm gonna bump up my starship shield emitters because I've definitely been taking a lot more damage to my shields than I've needed to lately. Didn't I just spend them? Why aren't you letting me spend them? Or maybe I already spent them and now I'm getting more. I don't know, that's kind of weird. Okay, driver coils are maxed out. I'm gonna bump up my hull repair. Right. This is what we are going back to find out about, because, as you can see from our position, we are on our way to the Sol system, and we are going home. Specifically to talk to a Lieutenant Vera, who is a furry cat-like dude, who will help us on our way to getting duty officers, which we can then send off on away missions. And the different away missions give you rank-ups in these. You can also send them off to the research and development, the school. You see, we have no duty officers, and that's kind of a pain, but what can you do? Excuse me. And, so basically, if you've played Star Wars The Old Republic, this is not unlike where you send off a member of your crew to do a mission with the possibility of getting either crafting materials or actual ship parts. It's quite cool in that respect. And, should be a bit of fun. Well, actually, it won't be all that fun, so... Mark 4, enter Sol system. Ah, yes. And we're going to beam down Starfleet Academy, hand that in. Oh, yeah. Life's going to be good. If you're wondering why I haven't bothered showing any of the merchant stuff, it's merchant stuff. You know, it's the same as it is in WoW or Star Trek The Old Republic or any other MMO. On the plus side, we've been here before, so this is nice and quick. Itchy nose. Wow, those Iconian ships look awesome. We will eventually get to that episode. Or that season, whatever it's called. Okay. Why? Okay. Lieutenant Farah, as far as I can remember, is over here. Could be, aha. Oh yeah, it's him. All right, that was easy. Hey, furry. Okay, hang on. I need to, I probably actually need to open, oh no. Okay, so we talked to Lieutenant Vera. Your initial complement of duty officers is now available. You will receive the following: a trader, a diplomat. Actually, that's not bad. Some of them have some pretty decent skills too. You can see they have different symbols, like cunning, founders of the Federation, which means they belong to a race that were involved in the founding of the Federation, which gives them extra standing in diplomacy. tactful, that's kind of obvious, and teamwork, they work well with other people. Unlike, say, this Andorian, who is emotional and honourable. So yeah, we'll take them. And there's no need to actually go through that, because I've done this before. Okay, so this is our roster. And as you can see, he's particularly good. Specialization, energy weapons, what have you. So that's nice. And if we just collapse all of them. So we've two civilians, two medical, three science. Actually, his science is pretty damn cool. He's peaceful. Okay, so assignments. What do we have? So, as you can see here, basically, you have different requirements for an assignment, but also hints as to what will be absolutely disastrous, like aggressive and unruly happens a lot. Let's see, entertain foreign dignitaries. Okay, do we have any short ones? We do not. Wow, we don't. This requires congenial, efficient, and eidetic memory, successful advisor. So you go in and you plan it. The planning of it is pretty simple. And as you can see, we don't have any duty officer who's any good for that. Which is kind of a pity. Okay, this is an uncommon. Let's see. They each have tactful. So we can actually select both of them. We don't have a third officer that suits, apparently. So we will select you. Tactful. Yeah. Weird, why is that not? Okay, apparently we can't do that either. We need to do simpler ones. Simpler. Do we have any that are low? Ah, this one we could do, probably. Credentials of a geologist, plan. Select, assign slot, begin assignment. So that one is going, and we don't have a biologist, so we can't do that. Basically, if you have a red mark, you don't have the ability to do it. I can do this one, and we can begin that assignment. That's 20 hours, and that's basically what we can do right now. So yeah, that is duty officer assignments in a nutshell. Just send. Okay, Karnan system report. I've received a report on the securing of the Karnan system. Well done. Okay, that one's cool. That one's done. A new officer. Haha. Now, I have a second engineering slot, unless I've forgotten entirely. Trying to remember where everything goes. Yeah, we have a second unassigned engineering slot, so we're going to grab the engineer. Let's see. Greetings, Captain. Choose join if you wish to join me to join your bridge officers now. Yeah, get on board. Come on. Chop chop. And I think that is pretty much everything we need to do, kind of housekeeping wise. Let's see, emergency power to auxiliary 1. It's not great, but it'll do. Can I promote her? That's the question now. Tell you options. Can I promote? She's now a lieutenant. which is awesome because that opens up another area of her skill tree. Or at least it will when she uploads, when she updates a bit more. Can't do those yet, so yeah. Okay, right. Let us. That's not what I want. That's not what I want. Oh yeah, I have to be outside to beam. I thought. Why can't I? Oh, there it is. Yeah. Is that it? No. Huh? This is really confusing me. And I've played this game before. Imagine not having ever played it before and you're trying to figure this all out. Whew. Shield emitters. Right. Done. Trying to remember how in the hell I screwed this hail Starfleet. Episodes, no. Available, yes. Gorn, halt the Gorn advance, no. I want to keep going with Admiral Jarrell Quinn. So we'll hail him. There are more reports than usual about Klingon and Gorn attacks along the border of the Federation space. Starfleet has created a task force to patrol the area. Proceed to your assigned coordinates in the Zarantine system. Begin patrolling. If you receive any distress calls, you're authorized to do what is required to help. And that's going to get me one of these, which is really nice. So we'll accept that. We will beam up. And I finally remember what it was. Oh, I can beam directly to Vulcan. That's interesting. I really must update my crew's uniforms. It's just like laziness. I am the laziest Starfleet officer in history. So we're going to go to Sector Space. My pretty, pretty ship. It's actually fascinating just being around the starbase. The number of ships you see is amazing. Okay, so Zarantine sector, there we go. I really have to get rid of this cough. Okay, and character. Now, let's see, that is a Mark IV. Yes, please. My shields are better than that. So where is my new officer? Yusa will get a new shield. No need to tank me now. And you get a new set of armor. And yeah, we'll give you a new weapon. There you go. You're welcome. Oh, she's injured. I had no idea my people could get injured. Can I promote her again, I wonder? No. Maybe I can promote... Oh, I can promote them all. They are all going to be lieutenants now. Nice. Right. Awesome. To my knowledge, all that does, by promoting them, you open up the possibility of them knowing how to do new skills, but you also boost their damage output in some way, as far as I know, but I could be completely wrong about that. And I cannot speak. Okay, let's recycle some crap. That recycle hyperinjection warp core. Where is that? Oh man, it's hard to see this. I actually find the the interface a little confusing sometimes. Plus 2.5 is plus 5. It's actually no better. So we got replicator and recycle. I'm going to keep that beam array emitter because I would like to set one of my ships up with a plasma beam. It's not going to give me anything but sodas. Let's get rid of it. Mandel Prime. Ooh, Borg Alert. We haven't done one of these, have we? Ah, they're gone. Never mind. Oh well. But yeah, those red alerts, there used to be a lot more of them. There used to be like 5 or 6 of them per multi-sector map. Like, for all of this, there used to be like several of those red alert things, and they would be like Klingons or Gorn or Romulans or Borg. And the idea with them is you jump in, you're instantly assigned to a fire team or a party, and you fight whoever it is.
The Klingons are willing to use any weapon available to destroy the Federation, even time itself. It falls to a small group of brave Starfleet officers to restore the timeline and rescue one of their own. Who controls this sector may determine who controls the war.
If you don't know what this is, you have not watched enough original Star Trek. That's all I'm going to say. And also, Leonard Nimoy, miss you, man. We miss you. Come on. Give me my goddamn patrol. No. Oh, come on. Task Force. Yeah, there we go. I really wish they would fix that. Yeah, very irritating. Task Force Hippocrates. To all Federation ships and ranges to the USS Boyce, we are taking under fire from Gorn fighters and need aid from any ships in range. Okay. Right you are then. Okay, this shouldn't be too hard. Thanks for the assistance. We diverted from our deliveries to deploy these emergency solar collectors. Now we need your help to activate them. Our starboard power coupling is blown and we're reading damage to our navigation system and warp core. If you can reroute collector's energy output to us, we can use them to keep our shields up while we make repairs. Okay, no problem. Oh, God's sake, another one? I did not expect this to be so tough. Lovely shield stuff. Oh, so apparently they can cloak. Or something similar. Really bad. This is crazy.
Target shield has failed.
I'd taken down one of them, they just launched another one. Ah, finally we're getting some decent damage in. Things are okay. I'm just going to pound these from barely inside weapons range because those things are dangerous. There's another one somewhere. That actually could be that one. Never mind. Right. Yeah, that was that one. Cool. Okie dokie. That battle, that fight took a lot longer than I expected, I have to say. That was kind of crazy long. Oh, and my apologies for the picture-in-picture crapping out last week. I still don't know what happened with that. It's rather irritating, to be quite honest. Oh yeah, I can do this, can't I? Fight like that. Please, not another fight like that. Walk to the Tapao. Okay. Carlos are holding steady, Lieutenant Commander. We can handle the air. Thanks for helping, and hopefully we won't be able, you'll be able to finish your medical deliveries. Good luck. Okay. Incoming message from Starfleet, sir. The T'Pau's requesting a ship to the ship. Yeah, we're not fighting these assholes. Not again. Seriously, not again. I hate the Borg. I hate them in Starfleet Command. I mean, in Starfleet Command, they were the cheapest race. Frickin' hell. Hailing to T'Pau, sir. Incoming message. Ah, there he is. He was just a pair of eyeballs floating. I am Salar, captain of the Vulcan medical ship T'Pau. There is an outbreak of Tacanian syndrome on the planet's surface. It is of utmost go away. There's an outbreak of Tacanian syndrome on the planet's surface. It is of the utmost importance that the medical supplies we carry be delivered immediately. Please accompany us and defend us. Okay. Do I get a choice in this? Is there a follow command, I wonder? Nope. There is not. That is unfortunate. Oh, not another one of these bastards.
Ship is under attack.
This is ridiculous. God, that was a struggle. Okay, the Zarantine system is not a location of strategic importance. These guards' attack must have another motive. Okay, that's nice. Doesn't really help me, but that's nice. Thank you. I'm gonna take this asshole out because it's really pissing me off.
Warning. Ship is under attack.
One down. I really hate these things. Now. Oh, give me a break.
Ship is under attack. Target shields have failed. Sorry about that, just someone at the door. So, dude, again? Oh, these are Klingons. That's alright. Klingons I can handle. Yeah, birds of prey. Warning, ship is under attack.
Bring on, Sarah. One down.
problem with the Goron Eagle stuff. As far as I can remember, their ships were really tough. They didn't hit hard, but they just hammered you under with by having just way more armor on their ships. Okay, this is starting to be a bit better. I'm not that talkative today, I have to say. I've noticed that it's not me. Presence of Klingon vessels in case the attack is not simply an operation of the Klingon Defense Force. Yeah, I don't think they're a defense force anymore, mate. Captain T'Pau is hailing us. Lieutenant Commander, we are detecting weapons fire on the planet's surface. My ship is on a mission of peace. We are unequipped to deal with armed resistance. Will you secure the areas our healers can transport? Yeah, let's go. Accept. Let's go. So, Star Trek news. They've showed on Channel 4 last night the first of the Abrams movies. Again. Don't I say again. One moment. I'm reading multiple Gorn and Klingon life signs between here and the medical facility. We'll need to defeat them before the Vulcan medical team can transport. The local security personnel are unequipped to deal with them. I'm also reading various life signs about the complex. Looks like some of the patients were caught in the crossfire. Okay. Cool. Whee! So, they re-showed it, and I have to say, there's a lot of it I'm not usually impressed with. Like, the whole, oh, by the way, now starships are absolutely and utterly irrelevant because we have interstellar transwarp transport. Yay! Take items. Talk to wounded security guard. Starfleet, thank goodness you arrived. We've been overwhelmed. Yada, yada, yada. Okay. Why are the Klingons attacking? As far as I can tell, they're ransacking this place for medical supplies. This is a research hospital with the best technology Santirin has to offer. Sarantim. What do the Klingons want with medical supplies? I don't know. The Gorn have been going through all of the computers and medical kits. They're definitely looking for something specific. It looks like the Klingons brought their Gorn allies. Yes, this is definitely some kind of shared operation between them. The Klingons are doing the fighting, but the Gorn have been taking some of the care of the science. They're the ones looking through the files and taking gear and sample containers. Stay here and keep your head down. We'll take care of the Klingons. Don't have to tell me twice. Okay. Anything good? Take. Chateau Picard, of course. Yes. Use console. Hospital services. This research hospital serves all the major medical needs of the Sarantine. The Zarantine Hospital, emergency services, regular pay. Okay, back. That's not it. Special services. This hospital includes developments from Federation Medical Research, as well as incorporating proprietary local therapy tracks. Our medical teams have new treatment methods involving gene resequencing, viral therapy, xenotransplantation to cure problems caused by radiation poisoning, diabetic defects, and unsanctioned Tucker contacts. Tucker? Genetic resequencing research. That's illegal in the Federation. Zarantine isn't a Federation colony world. This could be what the Klingons and Gorn are looking for. Yeah, you think? Oh, okay, so time to fight the Gorn again.
Enemy targets on offense.
Oh, come on, drop. This is what I mean about the Gorn being kind of cheap. They're hard as freaking nails. What am I getting lockboxes for? Take items. You have a lockbox. You need to buy keys for those, which I won't be doing. Okay, so that's two. Here we go. Where are the resequencing virals? I don't know, I'm just a patient, I don't know. Okay. Ah, Lieutenant Commander, you're early. Yes, I always try to be on time.
Flanking damage detected. Personal shield losing power.
That's okay, I'm taking care of this handler. Give me a break. God, Cola, seriously? Dude, take a chill pill. Now we've got a tactical kit, which is nice. Okay, so we need to talk to the patient. Why are you here? I'm being treated for Tachanian syndrome. There's some kind of outbreak lately. I don't know much about it other than the doctors say I need to transplant a transplant of my own bone marrow, resequenced and cloned. Okay. Are you behind a force field? No, the Gorn and Klingons put those force fields up when they arrived. They didn't want any of us to escape. Most patients here can barely stand. We're not going anywhere. What did the Gorn want with you? He was asking me about medical about all the medical supplies, the resequencing virus, the cell growth chambers, everything. I don't know about these things. I'm just a patient here. Resequencing and cloning, they're stealing materials used for genetic augmentation. The Klingons never had any luck with augmentation. Their attempts to use the augmentation virus in the 22nd, 23rd centuries were disasters. Why would they be bothering again? The Klingons have never been ones to reopen an unsuccessful line of inquiry. Okay. Where is the Gorn Haddock? Where are you, mate? Ah, there you are. Lizard and fly game, I like that.
Enemy target on center.
Oh yeah, we're going all Captain Kirk on his ass. Seriously, I need to find the Star Trek battle music, you know, the hand-to-hand combat music, because seriously, I'm James T. Kirking this guy. Okay, take items. We have a new personal shield. Okay. Signal Captain Seller for beam down. That's that, and we are done. Talk to Captain Seller. Although this facility has sustained some damage, I expect that my crew will be able to restore this wing to functionality in 52.3 minutes. Could you be a little bit more precise, please? Your decisive action has potentially saved the lives of many patients. While the hospital may be saved, I'm still concerned about what the Gorn may have stolen. I cannot speak for the larger issues of the Gorn and Klingon attacks. Logic suggests that if the Gorn left any clues behind, my crew will find them while they are making repairs. Do not hesitate to speak to them further for further information. You may depart at your leisure, basically. Accolade, aiding the aid givers. Area is secure. Okay, I'm gonna actually ask a few questions. What is Tachanian syndrome? A rare virus that attacks the blood cells of some humanoids. The disease was first diagnosed 7.6 years ago on Tachan 3. Victims of Tachanian syndrome slowly stop producing red blood cells. If left untreated, the disease is always fatal. What's the treatment? We will administer a series of injections to the patients over the course of the next 3 weeks. Probably through their belly button or somewhere really painful. The treatment can be uncomfortable, see? But if given in time, the recovery rate is 100%. Okay. Who developed the treatment? A team of Starfleet Medical used the Fabrini cure for, and I'm going to try and pronounce that, discovered by Ambassador Spock and Admiral Leonard McCoy in 2268 as the basis for the treatment. Unpronounceable and Tachanian syndrome are similar in nature. The Vulcan Science Academy is attempting to determine if the two diseases are linked in some way. Okay, I'm done with you. Yeah, we're done. Depart system. Let's get out of here. Well, that was moderately successful. And this is actually just... We're now at a... In a different storyline, basically. Good work, Lieutenant Commander. I'm looking forward to reviewing your report. On first glance, it's clear the Klingons are doing something with genetic modification. Since they don't have their own equipment, they're stealing ours. It's a bad road, and I suspect there's worse news to come. Do I have to pick one? I do not have to pick one. I can continue.
Congratulations, Lieutenant Commander.
Click here to view your traits.
I will in a moment. Exit. Drake, I will deal with you later, my friend, but not right now. Okay, so how do we...
These are your active traits. You can activate available traits from the list on the left.
Average 50/50 gain the ability to pick 4 passives, space passives, 4 ground passives. Okay. Non-combat map, okay. Oh, I don't have any reputations, so... I opened this like in the last episode, that's ridiculous. Anyway, spend some skill points. Excuse me. Ow. And, yeah. Subsystem repair, maybe. Warp core efficiency. Structural integrity. That might be worth doing, actually. Actually, I'm gonna buff up my energy weapons because I'm having serious problems causing any kind of significant damage. Right. My apologies. Today was not a particularly interesting episode, other than my sheer frustration with those support ships. I hate fighting the Gorn. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed it. I can't say I did today. That was really frustrating. But yeah, I'll talk to you all again soon. So have a good day. See you later, pink skins. Bye.